Hi, I'm Alistair McCaig, one of the analysts at IG, and I'd like to talk to you today about the macro issues facing the euro-dollar currency cross. Obviously, with the euro-dollar currency cross, there are two sides to this equation. Firstly, the dollar. The ongoing debate as to US tapering and when it will actually start, and the reduction to the quantitative easing process that the Americans and the Fed specifically have been overseeing is one that's hung around the market for some considerable time. Certainly September was anticipated to be the starting point, and certainly bond markets had pretty much fully factored this in, and we had been looking for about $10 billion to be chopped off of that monthly quantitative easing. However, that didn't materialize, and certainly the commentary coming out of the Fed, and specifically Ben Bernanke, has maybe pointed to the economic data coming out of America needing to be a little bit stronger, unemployment figures looking to be a little bit better, and maybe some of the manufacturing and services figures, again, needing to just be that touch stronger. Maybe looking forwards, we still would anticipate 2013 to see some sort of tapering beginning, but it's possible it's maybe only going to be about $5 billion rather than the $10 billion. Second part of the equation, of course, is the euro. And a major hurdle has been cleared as far as the eurozone is concerned, with the German elections now out of the way. Angela Merkel has come back in with some very impressive figures, the strongest since 1990, not quite strong enough to form a party all on her own. And once again, it will be a coalition that needs to be formed. It looks very much like this will be the SPD that'll come to the party, but that won't be confirmed for some time yet. Now that this election's out the way, it does mean that some of the other issues that the eurozone has had and possibly be put on the back burner might come back into focus. By that, we're specifically talking about the likes of Greece, for instance, needing its next tranche of bailout funds. The Greek government has found it very difficult to force upon their populace the austerity measures needed to really tackle their deficit, and certainly their GDP hasn't really risen at all and to help out that equation. So it'll be interesting to see how accommodating the Troika are as far as Greece is concerned. The other issue that maybe has come back to the table again was yesterday Mario Draghi, the ECB president, reiterated that he would be willing to flood the banks with liquidity to ensure that rates don't rise. This, of course, does mean that eurozone interest rates unlikely to go anywhere anytime soon, certainly part of the considerations when looking at the euro-dollar cross. For all of this and further analysis, please go to IG's website, www.ig.com. Have a good day.